A link has been posted to your Facebook feed. Winner, for 2018, the Jeep Wrangler gets a beefier roll cage, aluminum body panels, drop windshield, plastic fenders and 33-inch tires, for the Rubicon. All the better for off-roading, photo, photos by Henry Payne / The Detroit News, by photo. This year was dominated by headlines about the driverless future. Chevy rolled out its autonomous Bolt fleet in San Francisco, I drove a Caddy hands-free across Texas, then hailed a headless Uber in downtown Pittsburgh. Yet, the number of driver-focused cars multiplied like rabbits. Make that jackrabbits. Looking over the 40-plus entries for 2017 Detroit News Vehicle of the Year, there wasn't a dog in the lot. Even five-door, family-friendly SUVs often advertised their athleticism first, utility second. Credit in part the same electronics that are pushing autonomy with making cars more engaging to drive. Vehicles today are routinely equipped with electronic controlled steering, shocks, all-wheel drive and transmissions that can be altered for performance on road or off with the push of a button. Quick-shifting 10-speed Honda Accords, twin electric motor torque vectoring Acura MDX hybrids and spool valve demp Chevy Colorado pickups feature high goodies you'd expect to find on supercars. SUVs continued their march to world domination with everything from the quick Alfa Stelvio to quirk box Kia Soul Turbo to rolling condo Lincoln Navigator. But the endangered sedan species isn't going quietly. Kia debuted a saucy Stinger sedan hatchback that conjures Audi A7 performance numbers for half the price. Another $10,000 below the Stinger is another, all-wheel drive five-door stunner, the Buick Regal Sportback. From the get-go this year the headliners were performance models. Self-drive. No, let me drive. Dodge's Demon eclipsed Hamilton as the most talked about show in New York City when it bowed in the Big Apple with a mic-dropping, 965 second quarter-mile run. There was the Lexus LC500 and Porsche 911 GTS and Ford Mustang GT and Tesla Model S P100D. Pardon me while I pick my jaw off the ground. Our three finalists were old nameplates with new twists. The envelope, please. First runner-up, Ford GT. No, you can't have one. Priced north of $450,000 with all 750 copies spoken for, the GT is a rare beast. But it is a street-legal manifestation of the industry's state-of-the-art. It is the most beautiful car made today. From its heritage GT40 beak to its scissor doors to its inspired twin flying buttresses, it is Ford's Mona Lisa. Lap any auto show floor in the world and it will be the image that is burned into your brain. First runner-up, from scissor doors to its aerodynamic, keel chassis design, the Ford GT is the industry state of the art. Photo, The Detroit News. Its performance is even more breathtaking. Flogging its 647 horses around Salt Lake City's Utah Motorsports racetrack just 3 inches off the ground, I was at one with a piece of automotive history. The GT's carbon fiber chassis was purpose-built to do one thing, win lemons again 50 years after its grandfather, GT40, drubbed rival Ferrari. The keelwing design is right out of modern racing, with its long, stiff spine optimized to force air through huge channels under the skin and suck the car to the ground.